In this video, I'm going to show you how to use probably my very most favorite feature in the Astra Pro theme, and I'm going to show you how to use it. It's called custom layouts. I'm going to show you how to use it in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button, and to not miss a thing, go ahead and click on that bell. This is going to be on the Astra Pro. So Astra is a free WordPress theme that has a paid extension. If you want to check that out, it's WPCrafter.com/Astra. So this is just going to be for people that have Astra Pro, but what I'm going to show you how to do is going to work with all the page builders. So if you're using Elementor, Beaver Builder, Divi, Thrive Architect, or Breezy, or you know, whatever page builder you're using, this is all going to work with all of them. So today, I've been wanting to make this video for a while because I've been using it for a while, but today I was on Elementor's website, and if you see anything different, it's at the very top of Elementor's website. It's they added this before. This is what the website looked like, and then they added this little section to the top of their website, and it says, you know, some text here, and we've got a button, and then we have a countdown timer on the right. And so I thought, wow, I really like that. I wonder if I could do the same thing. So here's my website, and this is what I designed today. And I did this using the custom layouts, but you can do a lot of things with this, and I'm going to show you. But I just wanted to just first show you what I was able to do today. Really easy, basically copy the design right here and do it for me on my website using Astra Pro. But what's nice is you can create sections like this that you can slip into a numerous amount of locations on your WordPress web design. Let me show you another custom layout that I have, and that's at the bottom of my website. So right here's my website's footer, and this is generated by the theme, and then I have a section just above it. And you can see when you hover over it, it just has this little effect. I'll probably change this soon, but it's what I've been rolling with for a while, and I made the same background color black that I have with the footer here area here. I'm going to actually redo the whole thing, but this is just a custom layout. So let me show you what this custom layout thing is all about and some of the things that you can do with it. So here I am on a fresh WordPress installation that happens to have Astra Pro on it. First, you're going to want to make sure that the custom layouts is enabled, and you do that by going to Appearance, and then you go to Astra Options right here, and you'll scroll down, and it's right here, Custom Layouts, and I don't have it activated. Let me go ahead and click on Activate. Now, if you already have Astra Agency, some of the demos for Astra Agency are actually built using custom layouts, when you see some of the tricked out stuff that they do. So when you first activate it, it's going to add a menu item here. We'd have to refresh this, or let me just click on Dashboard to force a refresh. And now when I go under Appearance, we have custom layouts. So let's go ahead and, well, it looks like I already have two there. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Add New. And before I give it a name, let me just tell you what we're doing. You can have as many of these as you want. You just give it a name. You can build it with your page builder. So whatever page builder you have, it'll have a button for that. I just happen to have Elementor on this website right now. And here's where the power of this custom layout thing comes in. So right here, there's this option. It says custom layout settings. It says layout. And we have this drop down. So you can use custom layouts to design a header for your website, or a footer for your website, or a 404 page, or what I'm using on mine, hooks. So it's simple. You would just choose header, and check this out. This is where this feature, my love for this feature, comes in, because being able to create a header, okay, great. Footer, oh, whatever. Hooks, even that, whatever. Where it's really special is the display on in the user rules. So I can create this custom layout, and right here for display on, I could choose exactly where this will be viewable on this website. So if I wanted a custom header for just blog posts or just certain pages, or just say I have an online course website and I want a custom header for those lesson pages or whatever, you can zero in very easily having a custom header for just the content you want. But you also can take it a step further by user role. And this would be logged in, logged out, everybody, or based upon the user role that someone is that might be logged into your website. So right off the bat, with this, you can create headers for your Astra-based website and have custom headers based upon where someone is on your website. Now, that's not actually how I'm using it. I'm using right here where it says hooks. And so when I go there, I have this other option that appeared called action. I know we're getting into the techie zone right here. So let me go and show you this. So there's all these locations and the names of them are all a little on the techie side. But if you actually read what it says, some of them, you can kind of figure it out. So right here, it says for header. So header before, this is the area that I have that Elementor cell notice on my website. I have it on the header before. So whatever I create, if I select this like here, whatever I create will now be in that header before. Let me just show you this. So let me give this a name and I'm going to just do something real quick. How do you like that? I named it Custom Layouts Are Cool and just something really quick. So you don't even have to do it in your page builder if you don't want to. You can. It's going to be a lot nicer. But just for the point of this video, I named it just something really quick. Okay, so now that I've chosen header before, I'm going to choose to display on my entire website. Let's keep this real simple. And I'll go ahead and click on publish. And so here is that website, the front end. If I do a refresh, we're going to see now I've got that, what I just created, which is only this one line of text. It's right there in the header before area. But you can use your page builder to make something really beautiful, which is what I did right here at the top. I made this really beautiful section right there. So check this out. Say you're like, that's not exactly where I wanted it. Well, you can go here and easily change it. So if you wanted it at the bottom of your header, here's header after. Here's content before, content top. So you can play around with this and get your piece of content exactly where you want it. Have you ever been to a blog and you're reading through the blog post? It's a great blog post. You're trying to get down to the comments and you see this, maybe this square, and it says, hey, opt in and subscribe and this, that, and the other, and it looks real fancy and it has a different colored background. Well, that's what you use this for. You would go here and you would create it in your page builder, and then you could go right here and there's an option for this content bottom. And you can just slip that right in, and then you can use the display rules to maybe have some specific to certain types of content. That's how you do it. So, down here, you don't see it because it's cut off on the screen. We have footer before and footer after and on the bottom and all that kind of stuff. So this is custom layouts. It is insane what you can do with it. And this is probably one of the main reasons I use the Astra theme. There are other themes that have this kind of feature called hooks, but none of them have an interface like this where you've got this display targeting rules and the user rules and all that kind of stuff, this visibility stuff. None of them have that. So let me give you just a couple real world examples of where I've seen these hooks being used. But just keep in mind, I'm going to show you where it's being used on some websites so you can get some ideas and get the juices flowing of how you can leverage this feature in the theme. And most people probably didn't even know this feature existed, but it's really easy to leverage on your website. But keep in mind, I'm going to show you, you have these targeting options. Okay, so here is the membership guides, but they're also guiding you. And so what's the first thing I see? Here's a hook area right here where we have this call to action and we've got a button and it appears just underneath the header. You could easily make something like this, but where you could take it a step further with the Astra theme is you could maybe have two or three different lead magnets that kind of coincide with the different categories of content on your blog. And so you can show one of these for one of the categories and it would show on all the content in that category or with a specific tag. And then you can have a different one for a different category in a different tag. This is some of the power of using custom layouts. So here's how they're using it right there. And I think they're probably going to be doing that down here at the bottom. Okay, actually, I think I'm just on their blog right now. Let me go into a piece of their blog content. Okay, so now we're actually in some of their blog content. You can see they have that same lead magnet. So you can use it for lead magnets. That's going to be great. And here's that other example where you would have a piece of content at the bottom of the content area, and it would be sort of similar. And there you have it right there. And obviously, you can also use the feature to create a custom footer if you like the way that this looked. I know with Elementor, there's a menu element, and you can also use their social media element if you liked that. And also this right here, this little bit right here, this lead magnet that you see here on the right, well, you can create those and hook those into the sidebar as well with your page builder using custom layouts, where you have the power of assigning these different display rules that are right here. So when you combine the ability to dynamically insert that content with the display rules, you can do some really, really powerful things. This has to be my favorite feature with Astra, and you can use any page builder with it. Just open it up in the page builder, create a way, and you can do some really amazing things. So anyways, let me know what you think about custom layouts. I'm curious, if you are an Astra Pro user, did you even know this existed? Because I don't think people know that this is there and the power, the true power of this. Let me know in the comment section down below. And if you don't have Astra, just visit WPCrafter.com/Astra. I have a whole training course I give people when they buy Astra. You'll get all the details by going to that link. I'll also have it in the video description box. If you found any value in this video, please give it a thumbs up. I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.